Alright, welcome back. So, looks like it's follow-up from our last fight again. Isolated Haven. Get alien alloys for 7 days of work. Commander, after your recent success, members of the Resistance in New Indonesia have brought us reports of activity that you may want to investigate. Not now. I literally just came from there. I can't keep flying to New Indonesia every time they have a new fun thing for me to do. Also, I lost the local chunk of Australia over there, which is a bummer. But, yeah. Can't keep going back over there. Gotta continue towards our objective and all that. We're almost done with this relay. Training completed. We have a new grenadier. Alright, let's go ahead and customize you then. Alright, welcome to the crew, Snoop Frog. God damn it. That's F row double G, apparently. So I probably should just keep training new ones. Maybe not immediately. At least once a month or so, we just grab a new rookie and throw him in there for some training, just so we can keep getting new ones coming in.
You will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Powered armor. Codename Goliath. Now we can make the Proving Ground Project's Wraith suit and War suit. New item available, Warden armor. From what we've seen of the aliens' activities and their lack of regard for human life, preserving those of us that are still around has to become a task of equal importance to eliminating the alien threat itself. The success of this entire undertaking hinges on our ability to keep our soldiers healthy and ready for battle at a moment's notice. In working towards that aim, our latest armor prototype utilizes more of the alien alloys than any we've previously assembled. And as expected, the durability and potential for damage mitigation is extremely impressive. Initial trials show the armor to be capable of withstanding a direct hit from a focused plasma at 5 meters, enough to increase survivability by a substantial margin. I plan on advising the senior staff not to inform the troops of any perceived toughness associated with this suit. I would hate for our forces to grow reliant on it despite our best intentions. New armor, Warden armor. Our new mastery of aliens, Illyrium technology, has led us to the ultimate of battle armor, the Warden armor. Illyrium-powered armor provides unprecedented survivability and versatility in battle against the increasingly powerful alien enemies. The big question there is whether or not the Warden armor is an upgrade for everybody, or something I have to just sit there and buy one of at a time and equip each individual character with or not. War suit. By harnessing the power of Illyrium, it may be possible to create a new heavy-powered armor suit capable of generating a defensive force field, not unlike those used on alien craft. We're already getting another, advanced combat suit? Wraith suit. Having seen the aliens manipulating sonic fields for a variety of purposes, we've theorized that it may be possible to traverse through the physical confines of our world by developing a psionic field enmeshed in a specially designed light armor suit. Wow. We are actually running low on things that you can research here. Let's see. I could go for the plasma rifle. Or the berserker. Oh, oops. Or...
There is something exciting about working under the more intense conditions found on the Avenger. Every decision, every development is of the utmost importance. There's no room for mistakes here.
Commander, the Shadow Chamber is up and running. All we have to do now is put it to use.
And that's exactly what I'm planning on doing. All research projects will be suspended, yes. They already are suspended. The whole thing I did. Well, not suspended. I finished my, I was done with my research. Hello, engineering. She is not here. I didn't realize that she would come here, too. Let's see, armor? It's a squat? Yeah, it is a squat upgrade. But I need 300 supplies! Ah! Alright, well, after our next fight, we'll have a significant upgrade for everybody, I think, for defense. Increasing survivability yet again. I mean, our number of deaths and constant risk of death plummeted the moment we got the other set of armor, so this will be a good deal. Advanced Grenade Launcher. Our advanced grenade launcher uses magnetic technology to propel grenades further than our conventional launcher, which is great news to me. I may go for that, actually. I don't... Psionic Amp is not something I'm doing yet. Let's get that grenade launcher. Yeah. I want that. I want my grenades to fly further.
The troops have been keeping count on alien kills. Might be a useful recruiting tool.
Since I'm so prone to spamming my grenades anyway. Alright. Back to making time progress forward. Alien infiltrator. There we go. Now there's gonna be mudmen everywhere.
Long live the resistance.
But hey, increased income. There we go. Now we get to start making contact with the next little nightmare location over here. I'm sure it'll go great. It's gonna go fantastically, no one's gonna die, we're all gonna die.
Setting course for the Western European Ward.
I'm gonna run out of intel at this rate. Crap. I'm hoping that researching stuff at the... I don't know, but I'm hoping that researching stuff at the Shadow Lab or whatever it's called will give me more intel, because those are literally us digging into enemy technology, and I don't know, in a weird sort of way, you would think that almost everything we do would give us intel.
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
Because of what what the word intel means.
Still can't believe it's come to this.
I truly hope those gruesome images are the worst of what we find today.
They're slaughtering us, Doctor. What could be worse?
We're about to find out. I've patched the Shadow Chamber directly into the ship's computer. It's been sifting through the material we recovered non-stop since our return, cataloging sequences.
Genetic sequences, in near infinite combinations, yet all bearing similar genetic markers. Human markers.
There must be thousands of them.
Tens of thousands, and the procedure is still nowhere near complete.
Which is why we need the ship's computer to find out where they came from. By cross-referencing them with the data we've managed to hack from the Advent Network. It's an admission file from one of the gene therapy clinics.
Avatar. Just what exactly is in that vial?
In my worst nightmares, I would never have imagined.
Doctor.
I believe we have found the missing civilians.
That's impossible.
The gene clinics. Millions of people just looking for help.
Medically screened and selected. Suitable candidates taken to that contemptible facility to be processed, refined into the material we now possess.
But why do this?
I could not begin to fathom a guess at this point. There exists no research that would ever warrant this.
It's genocide, Doctor. And these people are walking right into it. We may not know what they're doing with this stuff, but I think I can find out where it's going. Got it. It's a high-security production facility. Standard defensive complement.
Then I strongly suggest we pay them a visit, Commander.
Agreed. The information we gain could prove invaluable towards stopping the aliens' true agenda.
New objective added.
Investigate the Black Site Vial coordinates. Alrighty then. Complete the Black Site Vial coordinates mission. Tell me more. Oh, those are just my objectives in general. It's the coordinates and then the Codex Brain. Look at all these completed objectives. I have no concept for how long this game is. If there's anything that's been true about XCOM games across the board for me, it's that I have no idea where they're going.
Objectives based on the most recent findings.
So my initial curiosity and excitement regarding to our earlier discoveries involving the recovered alien data have all been but extinguished by the disturbing results of my latest tests. Having analyzed the composition of the green-hued substance retrieved from the Advent Black Site, I can draw one conclusion, that the facility was designed solely for the refinement and production of concentrated genetic material, human genetic material. With the entirety of our ship's systems dedicated to the analysis, I found that the single vial we recovered contains the unique human genomes of over 1 million subjects. 1 million people convinced to join the Advent cities out of desperation, then subjected to appalling experiments that eventually cost them their lives. To what end? I can only imagine. I know I'm talking about a game with aliens and UFOs and psychic monsters and stuff like that, but I can't help but feel like that's an unrealistic thing to have happen in the story. No big deal, just, 1 million people walking to these clinics and stuff and, disappearing forever, and no one catches on to the trend after a million people. Seems like a very large number of people just have to disappear. Oh well. Space aliens, woo! But they're being awful. But I'm weirded out by the part where he says that he's totally, he says that he is totally unable to guess at what they're trying to do, but the entirety of the alien forces in this game, I keep wanting to say XCOM, and I have to remind myself that XCOM is who we are. That's the word is not the enemies. It just sounds like a bad guy organization, honestly. Their entire alien force is made up of genetically modified organisms. So, what do you think they're doing when they're sequencing 1 million people's DNA? Seems to me like they're trying to get some, they're just doing more research, gaining some kind of special power related to human genes, whether it be inventing a new monster or finding the secret things that they want to incorporate into their own people or something like that. You think that he'd at least hypothesize on that, at least. I don't know. The Codex Brain. This very well might be done before I finish. I don't know. How long does it take to do this? Make contact? Are we...
Commander, we have the coordinates of the Alien Forge facility. I've marked its position on the map. We'll need to contact the local resistance before we can attempt to move in, though.
I was slightly startled at first because I was like, oh my god, we're doing this now? Crap. I'm going to do something else right now. Black Site data coordinates. Operation Enduring Heart. The material recovered from the alien black site included a set of coded coordinates that led us to this facility. Remote reconnaissance indicates that a heavy enemy presence at this site. Investigate the facility and find out what the connection is to the black site and the alien's ongoing operations. Seems like something I'd want to have my upgraded armor for a start. Mission's locked because we need to make contact with the locals. Wait, is it here? No way, it's here? Wow, both of my next objectives of things I want to do are both in Western Europe, where I'm making contact right now. How's that for a coincidence? Gonna have to get some supplies, hopefully.
Made initial contact with the resistance operatives working in this area, Commander. They're going to show us how to get into the Alien Forge facility.
A few different things, huh? Hopefully.
New regional contacts located.
Yay! Ooh, continent bonus gained. Suit up. All armor and vest proving ground projects are completed instantly. That's cool. That is cool news. Alright, now we have access to... We almost have access to three different continents, bonuses. I need to rebuild this one by getting in there again. Let's see, none of the things on the table right now really give me supplies. But there's the nastiness. 14 enemies. Codex, Muton, enemy unknown. Advanced officer, heavy lancer, heavy mech. Oh no. Advanced trooper, sectoid viper. Damn, that is like everything. No Berserker again, though. Those guys just disappeared after one encounter. I'm sure they'll be back. But yeah, enemy unknown is worrying. The good news is there's no flying vortex man or whatever they were called. The god creature thing. But I'd be worried about the mech. Which, honestly, I haven't seen a mech since the beginning of the campaign, I feel like. They were the big thing that would crush my playthroughs, and then suddenly they disappeared. Maybe they're easier to kill now. It's a heavy mech, though, so he's probably a lot harder to kill. Then this guy's worth two victory points down here. Can I click on him? 11 enemies. Operation Flying Shriek. Muton, Heavy Lancer, Advanced Trooper, Heavy Mech. There's another one. Codex and Advent Shieldbearer. The Codex are just going to be everywhere now, aren't they? So these are both big numbers of enemies. Neither of them seem to have difficulties mentioned. That's interesting that they don't seem to say easy, hard, etc. But they're there. They're both right there, and they're going to murder my face off. So that's not good news. And very shortly here, I'm going to run out of intel, and I won't know anymore who's contacting. I'm gonna be caught in a situation where I don't know what the next month's objectives are, which is a bummer. Huh. I'm feeling slightly paralyzed for choice of what I want to do next. Well, we've already taken down one black site. It was a little tough, but it wasn't that big of a deal. This one has different enemies, so that could make it tougher. So I think I could go ahead and go for that now, and then maybe we'll go after the alien facility. So we'll get rid of their victory points to beat them back down and claim that. And then maybe I'll have money after that for the black site, which might be more dangerous, but I would like to give my characters their armor upgrade first. This doesn't really mention a monetary reward. I suppose if nothing else, I could just be passing time so that I can then turn around and do other things. I don't know, you can't gain intel. Wait, can't you gain intel at the Resistance HQ? Let's just go ahead and pop a save real quick. I'm going to make a save. 3/25/2016. Nothing like a save like that. Dated saves. To make it really easy for me to tell which saves which, but also really easy for you guys to tell how outdated or how last minute a video might be. Let's see here. Let's visit HQ. I saved first just because in case this might... This uses hours of time, so it might get me in trouble. Let's see, aliens are on high alert. Yeah, that's straightforward enough. There's no UFO, and they're not getting victory points, so those are decently good news. If I remember correctly, can I change what you do?
Welcome, Commander.
There you go, gather intelligence. Costs a little bit of supplies, but I'd have more. Can also buy these guys, but that's expensive as all hell. Yeah, I don't need healing. Let's switch you to gather intelligence. 25 supplies isn't that much. Intel plus 6. How fast does it go up? Oh. Hello. The Resistance has intel on a landed Hunter UFO. We can't pass up this opportunity to raid it for alien technology and supplies. Where is it? Alright, heavy mech is the biggest concern. Lancers are a bummer if they can get me down, but for the most part, soldiers aren't that big of a deal. Codex, Muton, Advent Shield Bearer. Biggest concerns I'd say are the Muton and the... Really just the mech. But that's a disabled UFO. That's worth supplies. That's exactly what I'm asking for. I guess I know what I'm doing now. Let's just try to survive a fight with a heavy mech and see where we go from there, right? Yeah, no, I don't think we're taking 3 snipers in. Not quite. Let's see. I'll go ahead and replace you. Hey, Rose is back. Hey, Rose. We missed you. You scary, scary goddamn ranger character. 2 explosive characters. Let's see. Make armor available. Make utility items available. Just to make sure we have them on the field. You have the heavy mech armor. You have the grappling hook armor, which might not come in handy here. What utility items are available? Stasis vest. I'll put that on my close-range character. Otherwise, we're good to go. You guys both have your weapons. You've got your hacker, if we ever feel the need to do that. And your med kit. You now have the ability to heal at a range, right? I guess there's one way to check. I think we got that last episode. There we go. He's able to heal correctly now. That was a bad surprise to have last time. You know, the mission does make a point to say that it's very difficult, so let's go ahead and replace you with a specialist that has more skills, such as being able to revive knocked out characters and stuff like that, because that character can only do the ranged heal and nothing else. There's simply better moves for him to have. There we go, Skulljack and Medkit. Give you a flashbang. Oh, wait, you can only have one grenade, right? That's frustrating, having one grenade slot option. Let's see. I'm a little worried about not having enough grenades. We'll give Notch here the flashbang. That should come in handy. We have a flashbang for reducing your enemy's enemy accuracy. We have two grenadiers. We have upgraded the range of the grenades. We're not going to make the mistake of trying to blow up a wall on the UFO this time, because that didn't work last time. Let's get in there.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Squad green to deploy.
It took some work, but apparently the Resistance managed to disable a UFO that set down in this area. Unfortunately for them, alien reinforcements moved in before they had a chance to pull anything off the ship. We're heading in to take whatever we can. Secure the site and eliminate all hostile contacts. Menace 1-5, UFO site coordinates locked in. Move to secure the area, neutralize all hostiles. We're in concealment.
You just gotta believe. Alright, well, the important thing about UFO landing is that at least we don't have to worry about time limits for now. Hello, UFO, that's on the other side of fenced area. Does that count as cover? Oh, there's a concrete wall underneath it. I'm like, why would a chain link fence give you cover? Against, like, energy weapons. Alright. There's an obvious force field there. And a few directions. Oh man, can you just hop on the roof and fire through the freaking skywall? Because that'd be great for snipers. Unless they get obliterated because there's a mech nearby. That's a worthy concern, is that the mech could just hop up on top and ruin everybody.
Confirmed.
Let's just have our careful inching forward. And, you know, believe in ourselves and stuff and things like you do. Any good cover? Not the best. Oh, hey, I can just hop in here. There's an open fence. We've got our line of sight. Spitfire.
On the move.
Let's just make our approach. Arvillo's here to cover you guys, unless that's not his name. That's Arvillo. Yay, I remembered the name.
Running.
We'll get everyone behind cover. Full cover too, which is pretty nice. This would be a decent place to have a shootout. That's two mechs. That is two mechs. Are they the only mechs? Because if I could wipe out all the mechs, oh god, there's a turret. I don't think that counts as part of the enemy count, does it? I don't know. They had time to set up turrets at their alien crash site? Oh wait, it was a landing, not a crash site in this case, wasn't it? Anyway. Turret is a concern. They're so disgustingly armored. But for now, no, they don't see me, right? So we're good. We're just around the edge of where they could see me. Let's see here. Can't really get the sniper to a lot of good places. Could bring him over here, for example, and that's about it.
Go, go, go!
Would prefer better cover, but we're a bit out of range. This one's better. Alright. Perhaps time to start planning an ambush, then. This character can't quite make it to cover because of all the other characters that already took cover in the way. He'll probably just stay back for the moment. We'll inch slightly forward. Alright, aliens, have your movement. Please don't magically spot me. That is very armored. How many hit points does he have? Like 15? And 3 armor? Ooh, look at them getting closer to the turret. I mean, if I want to be able to take them all out at once, this is probably my best chance. Would be trying to get them when they're all by the turret. What's my new range like, by the way? It's far. I feel like that's appreciably further than before, but still not far enough to do this particular purpose. But there's the rocket option, which unfortunately covers less area, but could probably be aimed to hit, at the very least, there we go. That would hit the turrets, the mech, the other enemy, and possibly another mech. But they're off camera, of course. We can't currently see the other one. A lot of it depends on what kind of risk I want to take here. It's worrying. I feel like there's a lot that could go wrong here. Real fast, as it turns out. Just how much faith do I have in these snipers? First of all, what's this guy's range like? You can see the heavy lancer, but he can't see the mech from where he is. Is it because there's solid cover in the way? I think we need better... I want my snipers and stuff in better positions before I do anything else.
On the move.
I'll risk them getting a slightly better patrol location if I can get my characters in a better spot.
Heading out.
Because yeah, my snipers need to have line of sight. Heavy turret. Yeah, right now he can only see the heavy turret, huh? That's because of the giant wall is in the way. There's the Lancer. Don't see the other guy. They're not spotting me yet, which is good. How about my other sniper? Whoa. Not you. Oh, the other sniper doesn't have a turn anymore, is why I can't highlight him. Right. That's me being dumb. See, right now we're still clear to go plop behind that tree. Let's keep pressing forward. Got our cover, so we shouldn't be revealed. Here is riskier. I can't really press forward much around here without getting in some trouble. Yep. That's every flavor of bad. So what can you see back here? Really, you can't shoot anybody from back here. Alright. We could have him run forward afterwards, or we could, let's press backwards with our assist Running character. The specialist needs to be here for coverage purposes. We can head forward with
Understood.
The solid character, at least. There we go. Nice and in range. If only there wasn't a wall right here. So that confirms the location of the other guy. Just plop it right there, and we hit everybody. The problem is that everyone's turn is activated, and I want some proper sniper shots and hopefully a kill zone if I want to get coverage here. So we're going to... No. Wrong button, sorry.
Affirmative, covering now. Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Just gonna tell everyone to overwatch, just in case something goes wrong, at least we'll get shots off, but I'm hoping that nothing will go wrong. Ooh, they're actually patrolling more in the open a little bit, aren't they? How far are you guys gonna walk? Oh, that's out of turret range. If we blast them, then we're not gonna get the turret at the same time. Still a good chance to get all the toughest characters at once. Alright, sniper, who can you see? Really? Just the heavy lancer? Line of sight is a bitch in this game sometimes. Alright. You can see them all? No, you can't see the... He apparently can't see the biggest mech. They must have line of sight problems. I mean, this is pretty much the chance I'm gonna get, though. Let's set up our overwatch and just plan our entire ambush here. I'll do a kill zone. Maybe as they run around, they'll make the mistake of running into my line of sight. He can cover a huge area, by the way, at that distance. If I tilted more, I could cover the turret, but I don't think that the turret can trigger overwatch because it can't really move, can it?
Lockdown confirmed.
That's gonna be my go-to. Chance of hitting is generally garbage from back here. Should I head? I don't think I can really go anywhere, though, to make it that better. What I could do is do run and gun to go sprinting somewhere and shoot somebody, so maybe I'll Maybe once again that character will hang out. Now those are some nice hit chances.
I'm on it.
Yeah, Zulu's probably going to stay put. And you're probably going to be getting ready to conceal somebody or something. Because he also can't really shoot people from back there. But you could have some fun. So I could do a rocket, but I think my go-to is going to be to do a grenade, because I can shred their armor, which increases the effectiveness of all the follow-up attacks. Wish me luck! Also, I want to destroy all their cover, so they have less places to run to. Not that the mechs particularly care.
Catch.
I'm jumpy about this. I haven't fought a mech in a while.
Bloom!
Look at that shredded armor. Some more shredded than others.
We're busted.
They're not gonna be happy to see us. That other mech just got away for free, didn't he? No one even shot at him while he was running or anything. Was that all that happened in my entire Overwatch? Is that what you're telling me? Are you shitting me? Wow! That's all I got out of my ambush, huh? Son of a bitch. Ah, 76%. 6 to 8 damage. 6 damage would kill him. I could take out my additional target that way. So run and gun.
Getting in close.
Sprint to this tree. I try, but I fail. Alright. Now shoot him in his dumb butt face. 100%. Better not miss a giant robot with a shotgun.
Enemies down.
Did my tree just... Okay, for a second I thought the tree disintegrated because it was invisible. Alright. If I back a little bit more away, I might be out of range of the turret. So let's plan that. Okay. Number of characters are going to be in danger right now. I've probably kind of blown it, haven't I? Rocket seems like the most in danger, right? Cover him up. And we'll keep an eye out. I'm really hoping that someone will be dumb and trigger an Overwatch still. Come on, you dumb mech. Run around a little bit, please. Yes? Really, that still didn't trigger anyone's Overwatch at all. God damn it. Oh, god damn it. Oh, god damn it.
They're moving around the side.
Everything's broken. At least, okay, at least that missed. That's something. Okay. Wow!
Fire spreading.
I thought I had an ambush set up. I really did.
Menace 1-5, we just picked up an outbound signal coming from the UFO.
Crap.
It's some kind of distress beacon.
And now I get
we
a time
need to get
limit.
Inside that ship and shut down the signal before they send their whole fleet after us.
I can do some damage, but not a ton. That said, practically everyone can be shooting at this thing at the same time. It can't stand up against everything, right? I guess we should prioritize people that aren't in cover already, though. Anyone who needs to get behind cover needs to get behind cover still, and then take their shot. But everyone's gonna shoot that specific character to try to make sure that he... What? You can't see him? Just because of that tree, you can't see him at all? What is this logic? Alright, fine. Frag that. Oh, crap. You're gonna blow up the cover? Damn it. If I'm not careful here, I'm gonna blow up the extra cover. I don't trust it. Line of sight is finicky as all hell in this game. Alright. I kinda wish that it had a simpler presentation of being like an old school, like 2D grid-based game. Just because... they're so strict with line of sight, but the environment is so all over the place and 3D and everything that it's very easy to think something you can see around something because the 3D characters can clearly see around the thing.
I guess that'll be okay.
Just gonna try to prep who can go after this guy, because we need to take him out before he does anything else. Who's really hurt? Is anyone really hurt? There's a little bit of damage. Yeah, there's 4 points of damage on our sniper here, and that's about it. Lightning hands. That's all you can shoot from here? That's a bummer. That's pretty much a guaranteed no damage. I guess we'll just take cover. Running backwards is just gonna be bad for us because we have a time limit here before we get in more trouble. 100% chance of poop damage. Cool. Just the poopiest of damage. How about Harvillo? Can he move? Harvillo can move. Okay, say we put Harvillo right behind him. Then our other grenadier could grenade this guy in a fashion that could take out the tree over there, but hopefully... Oh, god damn. Our grenades got really big, didn't they? It's actually hard to grenade this guy without blowing up the trees that we're using for cover. Really? You would take out the tree from that far away? Is it because it's connected to the freaking... I guess it's because it's connected to the fence? Like it's gonna burn down or something? I don't know. See, let's check our back sniper. Really, you can't see a single target right now, sniper. Not one. You can't see that giant mech over there or that giant turret over there? How's this logic work? I guess that wall's in the way and that tree is just the bane of my existence? God damn. The AI is really fucking with me here. I guess they perfectly... this mech just perfectly threaded the needle. He knew exactly where to stand to ruin me. Well, I'm still gonna ruin him. I was trying to find an elegant solution, but I think I'm just gonna shoot him a lot and then see who's left. 91% chance. I'm tempted to melee him, but I don't want to get stuck in the open if he doesn't go down. Just gonna have everyone take the shot who can. Yes, it is. I'm aware. Remaining shots. Lightning hands. Come on, 4 damage. Come on. Alright.
Armor still holding.
That was a coin toss, and I lost. I lost the coin toss. And you can't see anyone somehow. Alright. No, it's cool. I believe you. Half cover just seems like a gamble, is the issue here. And you've already moved. Let's just take your shot, I guess. There we go. Alright, who's left?
It's dead! It has to be dead! I think you should see this.
So our snipers are still up. Let's go frag the turret. And it's excessive quantity of armor. Because we need to start basically sprinting into that base soon. The game has such an exaggerated explosion effect sometimes. There's just debris raining from, I don't know, somewhere. Everywhere? Yes.
Get him.
Aw, damn it. Not a lot of damage there either. You can't really flashbang somebody. I don't think you can flashbang a turret. Maybe you can. There's been games that have had dumber logic before, but I doubt that works. There's a toss-up between... I could move forward to take a shot. He's the only character left. I was thinking in terms of, like, I could move forward to take a shot, but the problem is that there's a really low chance of me getting the hit off. Let's go behind this big wall. I'm not going to try taking a shot because I'm not going to get a kill. And so he's going to live either way and need to get taken out down by heavy forces. But I can get behind his big wall. Oh man, he missed. That's fantastic. We need to get inside that alien craft fast as possible. Best option's probably the sniper I just moved, because he's the closest to our target. And even gets free shots to help weaken him. Then everyone else can run towards our goal. Hey, look, a crit of the same damage it would have done if it didn't crit. Weird. Alright. Should be a guaranteed kill. That's the damage. Alright.
Target neutralized.
So now we have 5 turns to get inside the UFO as fast as possible, or we get boomed. Well, we fail to... Yeah, distress beacon would be bad. They'd get, I assume they'd get reinforcements, and that would really be bad. Because it's already a bit of an ordeal just to get as many killed as you can along the way.
Tired of waiting around.
Let's get our other archer behind cover. Archer, what? Sniper. He might be able to jack into the top of the car. We can't blow up the console, though. We have to disable it manually, right? If I remember correctly. Oh, wow. We can't even run all the way to the car. Car? UFO. Brain. That doesn't count as cover. Alright. Let's just get right the hell up in there. We're going to try to get everyone through this door and have a series of covered advancements, basically. What did I just press? Oh, no. My finger slipped and I accidentally hit a reload, so she wasted her free reload. God damn it. How is that the only action in the entire game that doesn't have a confirmed freaking... Like, they have you carefully confirm every action you ever take in this game, except that one, apparently.
Double time.
Oh, well. No one's dead yet. Let's just focus on moving forward. So you can stop your one action here, right, and grab it, and then keep going, I think? Yeah. You don't have to end your turn here. Expanded magazine. That's great news. I was not expecting the debris on the ground to ragdoll the giant mech. That was pretty great. Aw. Cover options are not the best. I can't even hop behind that cover over there. We'll pop up to this corner. You could move forward, potentially be in a better position. Right here, you have a line of sight of this door, though, which is nice. But over here, you could have a diagonal view. It's probably good to have a counter view compared to our other teammate, so we can aim in a different direction.
Finally.
Expanded cover. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh, no. There's a Cypher and 2 mutants right there. Hi. Well, it's a good thing a lot of us are in cover right now, but some of us are completely flanked, which is bad news. Snipers, first of all, let's find out who you can hit. Fucking grapple. Right up on there, huh? Does that help with flanking at all? Not necessarily. And does that count as cover? It looks like it's gotta count as cover, right? Let's get up there.
Hello, friend. I'm here to end you. And only you.
Please die. Please. Just sit down. Stop breathing. I say to a mechanical creature. Wow, a crit for 9. It's alive. 3 hit points left. There's the clone. Oh god, where'd it... Oh, okay, it's over here. Could have been worse. Alright, second sniper. Right, we have a cooldown on our lightning hands. Alright. So you can take out the codex. Or fire in a muton for, whoa, maybe all of his hit points? That seems like the go-to, right? 68's not the best. I'm taking it. We need to take these characters down as fast as possible. Hey, he's poisoned. I think we established last time that if he's poisoned, he'll die at the beginning of his next turn, so he's done. Codex is not done, though. There's two creatures with tiny amounts of hit points here to pester me. Demolition. Frag. Can I frag just right to hit the Codex? Because that's what I want. Oh, you bastards. How did you do that? Don't do that to me. Is it really impossible to overlap them? I think it is. That is really a bummer. That would have solved a lot of problems. I'm trying to be efficient with my damage, my attack usage. Alright. Well, let's get some of you guys get behind proper cover, first of all.
What's over there?
Let's get our support away from being flanked. Any specific gremlin heal targets? Let's take out the clone. Please don't miss. Please. There we go. Alright. Extra enemies down. Significantly reduced flanking problems for a bit. Zulu. Ow. Outside of the range of one turn. I just want to get a better position, but this fence is apparently in my way. Well, we're not in cover at all right now. Could go... no, we don't want to go stabbing, because they don't like being stabbed. Doesn't go well for them. Could go stab that guy real quick for 1 point. Let's review who else has a turn. Is it just you? It's our two. It's both of these characters have turns still. So we can explode the crap out of this guy, for example. What's your chance of hitting with regular attacks? 38%. But we could move to flank right there. Should be like a free hit. Okay. The question is where the melee even works on these guys. Haven't I meleeed one before, though? I guess we're gonna learn something right now. Come on. There we go, 8 damage. And then a weird delayed ragdoll.
Target neutralized.
Alright. No. Your Honor, I found all the bad guys. Every one. Holy shit, man. Alright, let's get you behind proper cover real quick, huh? Cause things are about to get pretty nasty. Okay. So I can't shoot that far. Let's at least get this guy.
Frag out!
It'll would take out his armor at least so that when we flank him we can get him. The good news is they're probably running out of enemies. I've out of troops soon. Jeez. I feel like I found most of them now. Well, you have an extra move at least. Not to the best positions I'd want, but I should probably move away from the muton that's about to cave your skull in over there. Is that the best call? Maybe on that side of the rock? Let's figure out what I'm doing with this guy real quick. You're armored at least, so if that guy comes after me, we should be able to take a hit. But I'm hoping to take out this guy too, right now. 6 to 8 damage. Yeah, minimum damage will kill him. We just have to hope we don't miss. Alternatively, rocket launcher. Oops. Could do a lot of damage over there while they're still in range of each other. But they won't die. I think I want to prioritize hopefully taking this guy down right now. Please, 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 yes. Man, wait till we get inside the ship, and there's enemies inside there, too. So Zulu's now the last action. At this point, I just want to get her away, because she's not armored. and I don't really want to do a muton melee, so let's get around this corner. That's a nasty trick, but also kind of... Oh, right. That whole pile of fun. Oh. Did he just go into Overwatch? You son of a bitch. He created a vortex. They created a vortex of that covers the enemy right now. Oh, God. How screwed am I right now? So he just created a ridiculous vortex that allows him to... Doesn't that thing explode or something? I don't know. It exploded last time, but I don't know if that was because the enemy was dead, or if that's just what it does after a turn. I don't know if it disables weapons and then explodes and hurts you, or if it just disables weapons and then that was the dramatic way of showing the field go away after I destroyed it last time. But there's the bad guy, and he's doing Overwatch. And probably no one can target him, right? One guy can target him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hit points. Plus armor. If we frag him, we can shred his armor. Looks like one thing about my character is not disabled, buddy. This will shred his armor, hurt him, and get rid of his cover. Which significant. Oh, his Overwatch is removed immediately. Wasn't sure about that. What? Okay, seriously, I need someone to explain to me how the hell line of sight and being able to shoot people works in this game, because I'm getting really frustrated with the way that, like, it just goes away sometimes. He was in line of sight a second ago. He hasn't moved. I destroyed his cover. Now he's not in line of sight. I can't shoot him now. Why? I'm sorry, but... An important part of a tactical game is to have, like, really concrete mechanics so that you can, you know, make plans and then execute those plans. So if I test the shot on him and it's like, oh yeah, he's got like a 50-50 chance of hitting him, meaning yes, I can aim at him and shoot him, then I'm like, okay, cool. We'll destroy his cover and weaken his armor so you can get the kill. And then I go back to him, he's like, nah, I can't take the shot now. How's that okay? Is that a glitch? Or is the game not explaining a mechanic to me? Or what? Like, that's so crap if that happens. Like, that really ruins my entire thing I'm trying to do there.
If you say so.
See, maybe we can get you in attack range or something? No. Ah, this really messes with me. If I go over there, can you see him? Let's see. Is there a way of testing whether or not I can target him at a given location? Right, it's the little crosshair on his character. So if I go here, there I can shoot him. So over here... I can only shoot him if I go and stand on top of the wall. I can't shoot him if I can't shoot over this lip, apparently, at him. Which is a bummer. I'd very much like to shoot him. But there's not great options for getting into shooting range on this guy without putting my own character in danger. Okay. Seriously, why can't I shoot him? God damn it. You guys all have disabled weapons. So one of you have a free reload. Reload. You're not affected yet. I can probably work with that, right? Let's see, this spot is full cover. Is it flanked? But that one says it's not flanked. This one says flanked, that one doesn't say flanked. Why is that one not say flanked? Weird game, man. Alright.
Let's move already.
Let's get behind cover here. And try to blow this guy away. 73, 6 to 8 damage. He has 6 damage health total right now, so it should kill him if we get the hit. There we go. We got our crit. With our last remaining soldier that could do something, I think, about that situation. Because no one can get to the cipher right now. The synth manster. Alright. Let's reload. Who needs a heal? Deadbolt, probably? Yeah. Let's go ahead and do that now. Running out of turns to get to that console, but they are hopefully running out of soldiers. I hope. So no part of the ceiling will allow me to shoot that guy. I'm wondering if I should just pop on top of this roof and overwatch in general directions and just see what happens. The first thing that comes to mind is I want to inch forward with this guy. And in a lot of games, I'd be able to inch forward with this character and go stealthy and go check out this direction and be like, alright, let's see what's over here. Because this guy isn't in line of sight of anybody right now. But the logic of this game is that enemies know where all of your characters are at all times once the cover is no longer active. So I can't really do anything with him for a while. I just need to do other things. I can't go on top of this roof, right? If you don't have a grappling hook, there's no system for that. Yep, let's just go ahead and just run forward. And be ready to help out. And you'll go into a long watch, because maybe that... Maybe she'll feel like running around in the open or something. So it does hurt you. Crap. Well, we know that now. I kind of thought that I left... I honestly kind of thought that I left the range of it, but I was wrong, apparently. That teleporting is rough. Please don't panic on me, buddy. Alright, he hasn't panicked yet. But the dude was careful not to go into sniper range. Well, careful not to trigger Overwatch anyway. Alright, so this won't quite kill them. If I grenade them, the cover would be gone, but I don't know if the game will just screw me again and be like, nah, you can't do that now. Sorry. Guess we'll find out.
Grenade out.
Die. Die, Stump.
Nope, there's the cloning. Other one's going back inside. They split 50-50 on the hit points. Can I shoot the one inside? No? If I move a little bit, I'll be able to, though. Alright, let's go for the sniper, who should have a good chance of hitting. Oh, right. Wow, yeah, that did not go as planned. My whole plan was to take out the cover, and then... Oops, the cover didn't get taken out. Well, crap. Are you the furthest back character? Yeah. We can't really flank with you. Not quite.
I guess that'll be okay.
See, what we really need to do is heal people. Especially you.
Gremlin medical detail.
Let's make these heals count, damn. Because the people have gotten quite hurt at this point. Alright, so he's up 7. Just trying to have a good approach here. But the cover is giving me some problems. 45%. 54%. At this point, I feel like I just have to take it. Yep, it didn't work. I figure what else is that guy gonna do this turn, so I might as well take the shot and just see if I get lucky. Alright, now for our contingency of figuring out what to do with everybody else. This guy can't even do an action right now, huh? Because his reload's gonna take a whole turn, unless I blow things up, basically. Which, you know, valid. This person has the ability to blow up either of these characters. 3-4 damage. That one has more hit points, but I could rocket launcher that one. Oh, do I not have line of sight? I do have line of sight. 4-7. Come on, give it to me. Launching. All right, that one's down. Oh, did we take out the walls this time? So the rocket launcher does destroy the ship, but the grenades don't. Well, now we have a line of sight, it looks like, or we're getting close to one. I'm really worried about moving my characters around because anything I do can trigger more enemies I didn't know existed before. I mean, I knew they existed in that the game told me in advance how many enemies there were, but I don't know they exist as far as, like, where they might be. I don't want to trigger new encounters in accident. So, at least get behind cover, I guess. Not that it necessarily matters, because he can... The pain in the ass can teleport. Come on. Let's get lucky. I lost my... There we go. I lost the coin toss last time, but I win it this time.
Who's keeping score?
Alright. Now the problem is that we're running out of actions to try to get in there. I want to inch forward, but I also don't want to die horribly, as it turns out. But he's got the closest access to the control console down there. So none of that counts as cover, but that one does. Well, at least move closer. No line of sight yet, right? Cool. Because he might be the only character that can hop down in time to trigger the console. But even that might not be enough. Let's see. No! I'm off by one No, okay, that one works too. Cool. I can go right here and trigger the console. So we have our way of stopping the distress beacon. Now we just need to deal with having our soldiers help out. This guy doesn't have any ammo. And if I reload, we lose our turn. So the best call probably is just to have him hang out in the back. We're almost certainly going to be sprinting somewhere with you.
Affirmative.
Let's get our line of sight. It's going to almost certainly trigger some kind of fight. No. Alright, I have no idea where the bad guys are right now. And it's problematic. Let's see, this one, this is the perspective I need to get a shot into the room.
Solid copy.
And with run and gun, she can take an action afterwards. There's our objective.
Menace 1-5, that's the distress beacon. Move in and disable it before the aliens get a bead on the UFO.
There's just so many directions enemies can come from. It's really worrying. Let's see.
What's over there?
Head forward again. And get another heal out.
Healbot coming through.
But at this point, I think I have to take the gamble. And it is quite a gamble, I think. See, we're gonna overwatch. In case someone comes into this chamber. I don't think we're gonna get much grenade use out of you this turn, so I think we're gonna come over here to cover.
That'll be okay.
And then reload.
It's killing time.
And I think Deadbolt's gonna end up trying to help out there. Let's get you behind cover over here. So he can snipe next turn if needed. Nice. Deadbolt's totally gonna come in through the roof. Literally on the last turn possible. On the last, pretty much the last square of movement possible. Please don't screw me with some sort of weird technicality game. Also, I'm totally expecting an ambush, and that's bad. Oh, nothing. Oh god, what if he's too bad at hacking?
I'll give it a shot.
Come on. Okay, so there's a 100% chance of success at winning at the fun thing. The mandatory thing, it's just the weird extra stuff. Scanning time's reduced by 50% for 4 weeks, and soldiers' hack stat permanently increased by 20. Those are both great news. I'm not gonna get either of them, probably, but at least I can stop the distress signal. Yay! Congratulations, everybody. Pat on the back, and so on. Can I use that grappling hook still?
We've knocked out the alien distress signal. Looks like the skies are quiet.
We got something over here.
Yeah, we do. Oh no, I was hoping to grappling hook him out. Oh crap. Please don't die. Please don't die. Please don't die. That's not a kill.
Shot failed to connect.
Live one turn, Raw. Just live for one. Okay. We lived, apparently. As far as I can tell. Hack workstation. Who am I controlling right now? Who am I controlling right now? You? It says hack workstation. I can't control anybody? Cancel out? There we go. I don't know what was going on there. I just hit escape. And it kind of fixed itself. Alright, there's three guys in here, but you know what? We're in here. We can make a mess of the things, right? Crap. You have to reload, and you have no grenades. Alright. Good job. Was he out of ammo when I first brought him in? I feel like I should have noticed that. Maybe someone was screaming at the screen at that moment. I have lightning hands. I probably should just take my free shot. The Lancer is a problem in general. There we go.
Went off the armor.
Grappling hook's also a free turn. We can hop upstairs. That doesn't necessarily help us avoid getting shot, because hopping up here doesn't get us out of line of sight. But I can hop up and move if I really need to get him out of there. But look, first of all, let's just see what I can get done otherwise. 55%. Only guy in range? Crap. Well, take it. It's free. Nice! No one's used an actual action yet, and we got one of the three enemies down. That's nice. I wish that I could see them with my normal attacks from here. But I can at least head this way to pistol flank someone. Which I believe is exactly what I'm going to do. No lucky crits today.
That armor's tough.
But he's poisoned, so he'll lose a hit point on his next turn, so we need to do at least 3 damage. Which shouldn't be unreasonable, because I can go stab it in the face. Can I stab the codex? From here? I can't quite make it. Oh, I can make it. The concern there is whether or not I'm gonna run up there and then reveal somebody new. How many squads were there? I took out the... There was the mech squad, the muton squad, and then a second muton squad, right? It was 2 mechs and a soldier, 1, 2, 3, 2 mutons and a codex, 4, 5, 6. I think it was a muton and a codex, 7, 8. And now it's this squad of 3, 9, 10, 11. These are the last 3 enemies. Okay. These are the last 3 enemies. So if I take the shield bearer out, I can just go stab the codex. Might even one-shot him for all I know. And then we're safe. Problem is, can anybody target the shield bearer? Well, this guy could run somewhere and shoot him with a pistol. That would work. Alright, that's what we're gonna do.
Tired of waiting around.
Run right up next to him. Hello, neighbor. I really hope this works, or it's going to be really embarrassing. In the face. He's alive.
It hit the plate.
Well, shit buckets. What are my other options? Spitfire. I really wish you had attacks. Can one of you guys, like, give him... Can you, like, airlift ammo into somebody's clip? Rocket has a frag grenade. A frag grenade. And I can move a fair bit, but not that much. Yeah, if I want to take this shot, I should have done it before doing what I just did. Oh wait, but Rocket has a full clip. If I get in the right position, I could shoot him probably, like right here. Ah, it's a gamble.
Okay.
I should take it though. No reason to stay put. Let's see. Pins a target granting reaction fire against the moves, imposing a minus 50 to aim. And if they do anything, it'll shoot them. Might be a better gamble than trying to do a frag grenade that could kill my teammate. don't know. Should I trust the range it says it has? The thing here is it's blowing up in a room full of enemies. It's like the chance of it... I think suppression's the way to go here. The thing about using frag grenade is that it'd be going off in a big room full of enemies. I mean, I keep saying enemies for some reason. Exploding canisters. Like, I feel like something's gonna blow up and make the mess bigger. Really thought I would make that shot work. Let's see, I guess I could also hope to see if, like, can I get awkwardly specific line of sight around here? I'm just waving my mouse around to see if I see the target line pop up. I don't think it does. He occasionally gets a line of sight on the codex, but that's it. Alright, Zulu. I'm gonna go for stabbing this guy. Please get in the right position. There we go. That's not gonna kill him. They'll just split them. We're taking it. Alright, he's damaged now. Now he's gonna clone somewhere. Oh, look! Specialist gets to be relevant. I just had the realization I poisoned this guy already. He's already dead. I just wasted my entire turn there. God damn it. I told myself I only need to do one more damage, and then I stood there after doing one more damage and was like, what am I gonna do?
Okay, I'll go.
So I should be able to shoot this guy in his dumb face. Alright. Wow, 10. Alright, so now we're down to the last wounded codex, basically. Everyone else is good to go. That guy's about to die of poison, so yeah, I totally wasted my turn with suppression. That was pointless. I'm pretty sure a second ago I even said, like, I just need to get him down to one hit point. And then I shot him in the face with a pistol. I'm like, hey, look, he's down to one hit point. And then I'm like, oh no, what'll I do?
My position's been compromised.
That's gonna hurt, but I should be safe, right? Yeah, yeah, you're not about to one-shot my character there. And at this point, the fight should be over, right? Bye. Revenge shot. No one's dead, but so many people are wounded, aren't they?
It's dead. It has to be dead.
Supplies, please.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
3 wounded, 15 kills. I thought they said there was 11. Maybe I'm... Oh! 2 clones. It goes from... Well... 3 clones. Yeah, 3 clones and a turret would be the extra 4. Yeah, 3 clones and a turret. It makes it 15 instead of 11. Damn. Got it. Everyone's alive. Successful shot percentage 100%. They really haven't figured out how to do that math yet. Maybe they just won't patch it. Yes, you've never missed a single shot ever. Especially not that one with the sniper rifle where you talked about flipping a coin. Alright, now let's watch everyone hobble through. Maybe I'll be lucky and no one's gravely wounded this time, because that's happened before. Fingers crossed! They all look healthy. Oh no. No. No, they don't. Both of the grenadiers, specifically, are gravely wounded. Alright, Spitfire. Let's see, the grenade in your grenade-only slot gets bonus use. I love that idea. And then holo-targeting shots give you bonus accuracy. Do you understand how much I like shooting grenades around? Because I don't think you understand how much I like shooting grenades around. Alright, our highest-ranking specialist got a level up. So these will be new skills I haven't seen yet. Covering fire. Overwatch shots can now be triggered by any enemy action, not just movement. That's cool. Threat assessment. Aid protocol now grants the target a covering fire overwatch shot, but the aid protocol cooldown is increased by 1 turn. It grants the target a covering fire overwatch shot. What? I don't know what that means. So if you... Wait. So covering fire lets you have an overwatch that gets triggered by anything. So I guess if you use threat assessment on one of your teammates, they get a special shot for free. Where, like, if the enemy does anything, they'll do their shot, basically. It's probably a decent idea, because I'm flat out not even using aid protocol half the time, because the healing often seems like a better option. Being able to, like, if I can trigger an overwatch action on, say, a sniper, I think that's something I wanted to have. There we go. Sounds good. God damn. So now Balls has 44 kills. He's stacking them up. So is Ra, though. Got another Codex Brain. Ooh. Clip size increased by 3. Put that on virtually anyone, and that's a big upgrade. If someone has a clip size increase and a free reload, they practically don't have to worry about ammo during the mission. Unless they're like someone that does a lot of kill zone, I guess. Intel is an important resource required to make contact with different regions around the world. To gain more intel, research any advent data pads or alien data caches your soldiers may have looted in combat. Scan at Resistance HQ with the Avenger, which will provide a steady stream of intel as you pass time. That's what I was trying to do earlier.
Shen managed to pull a set of encoded coordinates from the vial we recovered at the alien black site. And it looks like we're headed towards another as of yet unidentified facility. There are a bunch of theories floating around as to what we'll find. But at this point, I'm not ready to commit to anything until I see for myself.
Central, that's a weirdly late outburst. Alright, and certain missions give you intel, and so on. Okay. I might go back to... Oop. Settlements. 7 days... Ooh, supplies. That'd be good. I might go back to the Resistance HQ just to try to get more intel the way I was planning on doing it. But also, yeah, I might research those data paths to get more intel also. But we'll definitely want to get prepped for these missions over here. It looks like I just got the supplies I need for the armor upgrade. Squad upgrade, 300 supplies. Use up a bunch of our stuff, but make everyone's armor better. Absolutely.
This is our basic power armor frame, providing the durability you'd expect from a giant armored suit.
That's hilariously badass looking armor. I feel like we just went into a different genre of sci-fi in 2 seconds.
All those people, millions of innocent lives unknowingly walking right into the aliens' trap. We should have realized sooner. We knew the aliens couldn't be trusted. But their message has always been louder than ours. And they've certainly got a lot more incentives to offer in the city centers than we do out here.
Look at what these people look like.
We can't let this go on, no matter what the cost.
This is amazing. They're like ridiculous Power Ranger villains or something. Jesus Christ. The super bright color scheme I've been giving them actually just fits better now because they look like some sort of crazy comic book characters. Well, that'll make them harder to kill. Just need to get them all out of the hospital now. 25 days. Arvilla will actually not be out of commission for that long, but that guy will. Damn. See you guys next time.